Hey guys, welcome to a new video. Now, I should probably just say this from the start. Gabby said she needed a break, so this video will be just me, which is honestly all you need. But in all seriousness, it was a tough choice, but we are just starting high school and it makes sense to take some time to adjust. Not me though. I don't touch grass. Don't worry though, she will be back eventually. And by now you have probably noticed that the graphics look worse than usual, which, yes, apparently that is possible. I'm joking, Gabby. Anyway, this is because if you haven't been paying attention, Gabby needed a break. That includes editing. So basically, I had to learn to do everything, which, as you probably have noticed, I'm not very good at. So, sorry if it sounds or looks worse than usual. I'm not that sorry, I don't care. Hope you enjoy the video. No, I don't care. For now, enjoy this video, sponsor, Walmart. Hey, you. Yes, you. Have you ever gone shopping and thought, hey, this experience was too clean, likable, and normal for my taste? Well, do I got the place for you. At Walmart, I assure you 98% of employees will be in a bad mood, especially when you need help. Don't worry, there will also most definitely be other people's garbage hidden within the shelves. Have you ever wanted to see a kid throw a tantrum? Walmart has got you covered. 9 out of 10 kids will most likely be crying. And yes, the thing you really liked will most definitely be gone whenever you actually have enough money. Walmart, the place where you can find a Florida man outside of Florida. Now let's get back to the video. What do you mean I'm a sellout? So today's video, reviewing board games. Sure. First, let's start with the classic, Monopoly. The game no one wants to play because they don't have 5 hours to spare. What other game teaches you the troubles of financial debt other than Monopoly? And Animal Crossing, but that's besides the point. Anyway, Monopoly is that one game you play with family members and always have to strip the game down so it's not overly complicated. And also, I swear to God, if I play with another jail camper, I'm going to lose it. Well, that's assuming I have an it left. Next up is another classic. Snakes and Ladders. That's right, I said snakes, not chutes. What the hell is a chute? Yeah, good luck drawing that, Gabby. Oh, this script was written before Gabby told me she needed a break, and I kind of screwed myself over here, so instead of whatever I should put here, here's a clip of a dancing duck.
1, 2, 3, My baby don't mess around because she loves me so.
Anyway, the game is all about rolling a dice and hoping for the best. And for no reason, everyone gets so competitive, even if you can't really use any strategy in this game. I swear to God, dude, if you roll a dice a little bit weird, everyone stops the game to yell at you and make you re-roll. Of course, only if you got a good roll. Next up, seems like a perfect time to talk about Battleship. What could be more fun than guessing randomly and hoping for the best? For no reason, this game feels like it needs so much strategy for no reason, because the game is so simple. Most games go like this. D6? No. Dang it. My turn. G8? God dang it. Hit. Nice. Repeat until mass genocide is over. And on that note, let's talk about Jumanji. You know that one game we all got really depressed on when we realized that there weren't going to be like any killer monkeys or tigers coming out of the game? And it was just dice rolling. Okay, now let's talk about Pop the Pig. You feed a pig hamburgers until it gets too fat and his shirt pops open. Yeah. That's the game. Alright, whatever. Let's talk about the game of life. Rolling a dice, but with an overly happy life. So already it's fake. No one in life pays you 50k... for getting a pet. What the heck? Life is more sad. I want to play that one game from Malcolm in the Middle where the dad makes the game of life like really depressing. Next up is Uno. You know, that one game which is literally the only game you ever play when family is over. Over and over and over. And then when you're about to win, somebody calls you out for not saying Uno, and then you just internally die a little. After Uno comes Dose. You know that sequel to Uno no one likes except for me, and I'm pretty sure no one knows except for me. It's just Uno, but it really embraces the number 2. I don't feel like explaining it, so just Google it. And yes, this is technically what the video is supposed to be about, but go make your own video on it. I dare you. Explain the rules perfectly. Yes, what I thought. Last one for now, hues and cues. Every colorblind person's worst nightmare. It's literally getting a color and describing it to everyone else. As they try to guess your color based on the one or two worded clue you give them, it's honestly really fun. You should definitely check it out. I guess unless you're colorblind, so I'm definitely going to play this with Gabby because I have an advantage. And for the outro, let's talk about that one game that I forgot what it's called. But you would bang a plastic watermelon toy on your head and see who makes it crack open, spilling water on them. Oh, it was called Watermelon Smash. If I do this right, there should be a picture so you know what I'm talking about right about now. Anyway, bye guys, and remember, always wear your watermelon before life gives you a monopoly. What the hell did I just say? Whatever. Like, subscribe, follow our Instagram, and watch my favorite video we've made about us ranking chips, which is now copyright claimed for some reason. Thanks, Louis. It doesn't get enough credit, and okay, bye for real now.